Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh dan salam sejahtera. So we continue our lesson with cash discount. So what is cash discount? So cash discount is discount given by manufacturer or and wholesaler to the retailers to pay their bills or invoice within a stipulated period. Okay, so before this trade discount, so kalau trade discount we don't have the period. Kita tak ada tempoh masa. So kita beli je, kita dapat trade discount tu. But this one, cash discount, have the period, ada tempoh masa. So kalau kita bayar mengikut tempoh masa tu, kita dapatlah cash discount tu. Kalau tak bayar ikut tempoh masa tu, tak dapatlah discount. So invoice document sent to buyer, describe the goods and identifies the condition of sale and the net amount owed to the seller. Then credit terms. So what is credit terms? The condition agreed by the buyer and seller concerning the rate of discount, cash discount rate, time limit for the discount, and information about shipping. Okay, so that one is credit terms. Okay, so in cash discount, how to calculate the net price? So net price, the formula same as previously. So NP is equal to LP minus by C. Cuma kat sini ni C lah. So before this trade discount, so we use D. But here since here cash discount, so we use C. Okay, so ni simple ni tak ada masalah lah, apa-apa tak ada issue pun. Okay, so cuma berbeza simbol dia. Okay, yang kita tahu sini ni adalah discount. Okay, so example here. Okay, so explain the cash discount. Okay, so actually in the cash discount, so you will see this kind of number. So 3 over 10, 1 over 15 and n over 30. Okay, so what is the meaning of this one? Okay, so 3 over 10 actually is 3% cash discount or 3% discount will be given if the payment is made within 10 days from the date of invoice. Okay, so kalau dia bayar dalam tempoh masa 10 hari, dia akan dapat diskaun sebanyak 3%. How about this one? 1 over 15. So 1 over 15 is 1% discount will be given if payment is made within 15 days from the date of invoice. So kat sini, okay, so kat sini, this 15 days is starting from day 11 until day 15. So kenapa? Sebab daripada day 1, okay, so from day 1 until day 10, the discount is 3%. And then if, kalau dia tak boleh nak bayar dalam tempoh masa 10 hari, okay, so if they cannot pay on the within 10 days, so dia akan bayar pada hari berikutnya lah. So selepas 10 hari, so the discount will be reduced into 1%. So 11 until 15. Okay, so selepas 10 hari sampai ke 15 hari, the discount is 1%. And then if the payment is made after 15 days, okay, so selepas 15 hari, so n over 30, okay, so 16 until 30, so this one no discount. Okay, so dia takkan dapat discount, but the payment must be made within this 30 days. Okay, so last 30 hari lah. Okay, so macam mana pun dia kena bayar. Sampai 30 hari ni pun dia kena bayar. Okay, so here credit period is 30 days from the date of invoice. So tempoh masa ni lah. So last day is 30. Okay, so example this one. Okay, so an invoice 1680 dated 10 March 2003 offered cash discount terms of 10 over 15 and n over 30. So maksudnya satu, from day 1 until day 15, discount given is 10%. And then from day 16 until day 30, there is no discount. Okay, so 0%. So find the amount of payment if the invoice paid on 25 March 2003. Okay, so here we need to find from 10 March until 25 March. Berapa hari, okay? So 10 March until 25 March, it is equal to 25 minus 10 this. Okay, so which is equal to 25 minus 10, so which is equal to 15 days. Okay, so therefore the payment was made on day 15. Okay, so bayaran dibuat pada hari ke-15. Okay, so therefore the cash discount given is 10%. So the net price is equal to 2,681 minus discount given, which is 10%, 0.1. So the answer is RM 2,412. Okay. And then B. Okay, so if the payment made on 1 April, so 1 April, so from 10 March, yes, so 10 March until 1 April. Okay, so 10 March, okay, so from 10 March until the end of March, so we have 31 minus 10, which is equal to 21. And here 1 April, 1 day. So total is 22 days. Okay, so meaning that the payment was made on day 22. Okay, so here therefore there is no discount given lah. Okay, so selepas 20 hari, which is after day 15, so selepas hari ke-15, so bermaksud dia dapat discount. So therefore the payment need to be paid is same lah, RM 2,680, because there is no discount. Okay, next example. Noris received an invoice of 8,500 with cash discount terms of 10 over 10, 5 over 15, and N over 30. So find the amount of payment made 2 weeks from the date of invoice. Okay, so 2 weeks. So yang ni dia tak bagi tarikh. Tak ada tarikh. Tapi dia bagi tahu kat sini payment made 2 weeks from the date of invoice. So 2 weeks is equal to 14 days. So therefore she paid the invoice on day 14. Okay, so from this one, so we have 1 day 1 until day 10, so we have 10% discount. Day 11 until day 15 have 5% discount, and day 16 until day 30 no discount. Okay. So since the payment was made on day 14, so therefore Noris will get 5% discount. So therefore the net payment is equal to, or net price dia, okay, so amount need to pay, so net price 8,500 times by 1 minus 0.05, so which is equal to RM 8,075. Therefore, amount need to be paid. Is equal to RM 8,075 ringgit. Okay, so yang ni tadi atas ni. So, ni dia punya payment lah. Payment dia dengan jumlah yang dia kena bayar adalah yang ni. Yang sini, yang B ni, yang ni, okay. Okay, so next, so calculation involving trade discount, cash discount, and transportation cost of freight charge. Okay, so lagi satu soalan, dia menggabungkan cash discount dengan trade discount, and there is a transportation cost also. Okay, so sebab dalam perniagaan ni kadang ada company dia bagi penghantaran, servis penghantaran. So dalam servis penghantaran tu dia akan ada cost lah. But for the transportation cost, there is no discount given. Okay, so this one, the transportation cost or freight charge are not subjected to cash discount. Okay, so cost transportation atau freight charge tu dia tak dikenakan discount. So therefore, if you have this the question that involve trade discount, cash discount, and transportation cost, so first we need to subtract the transportation cost. Kalau ada lah, so kalau tak ada tak payah. Okay, so and then next step, so calculate the first net price after trade discount. Sebab kita ada dua jenis discount, trade discount and cash discount. So first find the net price after the trade discount, and then find the net price after the cash discount given. Okay, so we find first NP1, and then after you get the NP1, use the NP1 to calculate the net price after the cash discount. Or you can use directly net price is equal to the list price. So 1 minus trade discount 1, trade discount 2 until trade discount end. If there is a multiple trade discount, and then times with 1 minus cash discount pun boleh. Okay. Okay, so dekat sini contoh saya akan buat satu-satu-satu lah. Saya tak nak buat yang bawah ni. Okay. So siapa yang mahir boleh nak buat yang bawah ni. Okay. Okay, so example here. Encik Zaidi receive an invoice for 1,680. Okay, so 1,680, which offer 10% trade discount and cash discount terms of 10 over 5, 6 over 10 and N over 30. And if he paid the invoice 6 days after the date of the invoice, find the amount of the payment. Okay, so first checks, there is a transportation cost or freight charge. Okay, so ada tak? So kat sini, we don't have the transportation cost and freight charge. So therefore, the list price, so list price we take as 1,680. Okay, so tak payah nak tolak apa-apa sebab tak ada transportation cost atau freight charge. And then we have here trade discount offer, which is 10%. So first find the first net price after the trade discount given. Okay, so cari net price setelah trade discount. So 1 minus 0.1, which is equal to, okay, so which is equal to RM1,512. And then after that, find last net price, which is after the cash discount. So setelah diberi trade discount, diberi lagi cash discount. So for the cash discount, we need to choose which one. So one until day 1 until day 5, 10% discount. Day 6 until day 10 is 6% discount. And day 11 until day 30, no discount. Okay, so since the payment was made on 6 days, okay, so meaning the day 6, therefore the cash discount given is 6%. So therefore the net price is 1,512 times by 1 minus 0.06. So kita ambil yang ni, eh. Jangan ambil yang asal. Ha, sebab yang kita nak kira harga selepas cash discount tu, kita kena ambil harga yang selepas trade discount. Okay, so dia ikut urutan transportation cost, and then trade discount, and then last cash discount. Okay, so this one, we have the answer, which is RM1,421.28. So therefore, amount need to be paid, or amount of payment, is equal to RM1,421.28. So next, an invoice of 8,800 that includes a prepaid transportation cost of 150 dated 31st May 2002 was offered trade discount of 20% and cash discount terms of this one. So find the amount of payment made on 14 June. Okay, so first sekali tadi step dia apa? Transportation cost. Then in transportation cost of free charge. And then trade discount. And then cash discount. Okay, so first the list price. Okay, since we have here transportation cost, so the list price is 8,800 minus 550, so which is equal to RM 8,650. And then next trade discount. So trade discount given is 20%. So find the first net price after the trade discount. Kita ambil yang ni lah. Okay. So 8,650 times with 1 minus 0.2. So which is equal to RM 6,920. After that, find the net price after cash discount. So 6,920 times with 1 minus. Okay, so we need to find first which discount is given, which cash discount will be given. So the payment was made on 14 June, invoice dated on 31st May. So 31st May until 14 June. Okay, so 31st May until the end of May, 0 day lah. Okay, so sebab bulan 5 penuh 31 hari. So 31 minus 31, 0. And then 14 June, so for the June, 14 days. Okay, so therefore 14 days total. So the cash discount given in 14 days, so this 1, 15%. Okay, so cash discount is 15%. Okay, so therefore here last net price is 1 minus 0.15. So we have the answer is RM 5,882. Okay, so tak sama pun jawapan. Ya, memang tak sama, because this one net price for the list price. Okay, so but the question need us to find the amount of payment. So amount of payment is equal to so harga barang. Okay, so the list price, the net price of the list price. Okay, so harga barang setelah ditolakkan diskaun apa semua tu, which is 5,882, and then plus transportation cost, kena tambah lagi. Okay, so yang tadi asal kita tolak, kita tolak sebab kita nak kira diskaun, sebab transportation cost ni tak kenakan diskaun. Tapi yang kita nak bayar, kita kena bayar sekali dengan transportation cost, sebab transportation cost tu bukan free. So therefore the answer is RM 6,032 ringgit. Hilang pula. Okay, tadi korang dah salin kan? Okay. Okay, so next example. On 27 April 2001, a retailer received an invoice and the list price of the good book were as follows. Okay, so dried food, frozen food and plastic product. So therefore the total list price is 465 plus 230 plus 787, which is equal to RM 1482. Okay, so list price ni harga barang lah. Okay, so the trade discount given were 16%, 5%, and the cash discount terms was 4/10, 2/20, and N/30. So find the total payment made on 10 May. Okay, so here there is no transportation cost. So tak ada transportation cost, we proceed into the trade discount. So find the net price after trade discount. Okay, so since here the trade discount is multiple discount, 16% and 5%, so we use 1 minus D1 0.16 times another one, which is 1 minus D2 0.05. So we have the answer here, RM 1182 and 60 4. And then this one, net price after trade discount. And then next, we find the last net price, which is after cash discount. So last net price is equal to, okay, so we take this one, 1182.64 times with 1 minus the cash discount given. So kita kena cari lah dulu cash discount dia yang mana satu. Okay, so the payment made on 10 May and the invoice dated on 27 April. Okay, so kita check sini. So 27 April until 10 May. Okay, so for the 27 April until the end of April, we have 30 minus 27, which is equal to 3 days. And then 10 May is 10 days. So total is 13 days. Okay, so therefore the payment was made on day 13. Okay, so if the payment was made on day 13, so meaning that after the day 10, but before the day 20. So therefore the cash discount received is 2%. So cash discount received is equal to 2%. Okay, so next calculate the last net price. So here 1 minus 0.02. So we have the answer, which is RM1158.99. So therefore total payment is equal to, since there is no transportation cost, so we just take this one, 1100 RM. Lupa. Okay, so RM 1158.99. Okay, so next. Okay, so last example. A company received an invoice dated 25 January 2000 for the purchase of an item. So the invoice offered trade discount of 20% and cash discount terms of 3/15 and over 30. On 5 February 2000, the company paid 7,560 including free charge of 100 to settle the invoice. So find the list price of the item. Okay, so nak cari list price. Okay, so biasa kita ada formula dia, bentuk dia NP. Okay, so NP list price minus by the discount. Okay, so LP tu duduk dekat sini. Okay, so to find this list price, so first we need to have the net price, and the discount ni memang dia ada lah. So therefore first we need to have the net price. So this one, on 5 February 2000, the company paid 7,560 including free charge of 100. So this 7,560 is actually including the net price plus the free charge. So therefore the net price is equal to 7,560 minus by 100, so which is equal to RM 7,460. Yeah. Okay, so dia macam terbalik ke belakang lah ni. Okay, so first, kalau sebelum ni kita kira trade discount and then cash discount kan, lepas tu cari total payment. But here kita reverse ke belakang. So here after you have the net price this one, so we calculate NP1 from the cash discount. Okay, so the invoice dated 25 January. Okay, so 25 January. Okay, so 25 January. And then the payment was made on 5 February. Okay, so 25 February January until the end of January, which is equal to 6 day. Okay. And then 5 February, so this one 5 days. So total is 11 days. Okay. So for 11 days, so the cash discount received is 3%. Okay, so next, So this one net price, so 7460 is equal to NP1 times by 1 minus 0.03. So NP1 is equal to 7460 divided by 1 minus 0.03, which is equal to RM 7690.72. Okay. And then after you get the NP1, so we go to the trade discount. So for the trade discount, NP1 is equal to list price 1 minus trade discount, which is 0.2. So we have the list price, which is equal to NP1 divided by, so yang ni bawa pergi ke kiri, jadi bahagi 1 minus 0.2, so which is equal to 7690.72 divided by 1 minus 0.2, so which is equal to RM 9613.40. Okay, so since the question find the list price, so kita tak payah nak tambah semula dengan recharge. So this one is the list price. Okay, so kalau siapa yang tak faham nak undur ke belakang semula, so korang boleh buat macam ni. Okay, so this one saya delete dulu, okay. So buat je seperti yang atas tadi, kita ikut urutan. So but for the list price, okay, so list price this one we represent as X sebab kita tak tahu. Okay, so next calculate the trade discount, so NP1. So NP1 is equal to list price, which is X, 1 minus 0.2. So this one is equal to 0.8 X. And just now we already calculate the cash discount, so cash discount is 3%, right? Okay, so next find the last net price, which is equal to NP1 0.8 X times with 1 minus 0.03. So we have here, okay, so this one you can multiply 0.8 times by 1 minus 0.03, which is 0.776 X. Okay, so this one net price. Okay, so net price, so since the payment was 7560 and this one including the freight charge, so from this one we can find the net price, which is equal to 7560 minus by 100. So this one is equal to RM 7460. Okay, so therefore from this one and this one, so we have 7460 is equal to 0.776 X. So X is equal to 7460 divided by 0.776, so which is equal to RM 9613.40. Okay, sama je jawapan dia. Okay, okay, so that's all for our lesson today. So next time we will continue with parcel payment. Okay, so that's all. Thank you and Assalamualaikum.